gentlemen, we are back.
Wow.
Wow. That was an intense...
That was a crazy...
I really thought Deadpool was going to take it today. But we have a newcomer. It's Heel Life. And yeah, decisively, she took both.
Yes.
2 out of 3. 2-0 for Deadpool. And we are back with the underdog finals, or as I like to call it, the not winner finals.
The not winner finals.
Frank and Bean versus Heel Life. No surprise here. They've already selected their characters. Frank and Bean is going to stick with
Shock.
And Heel Life is going to go for
Ike. And both of them put up an outstanding performance today.
They have.
Oh my gosh.
Win or lose, it doesn't matter. We got some crazy impressed.
New people or underdogs, up and coming, headliners.
I can't wait for the next tournament to see if we'll have everybody here, like the former
champs and all that stuff.
I want to see them go at it.
Yeah. I mean, by the way, the last tournament, Sensei won.
Yes, I heard.
Yes. He's the champ from the last one.
Correct.
Goodfellas Games.
Woo! Do we have an early knockout?
Oh,
no.
Wait. Oh.
He's already at 98%. I want to elaborate how ridiculous that is. I call ridiculous.
So, again, this is sword versus sword.
This is sword.
Big sword versus laser sword.
Big heavy iron sword versus future sword.
Futuristic sword.
I heard Shulk's sword connects to the internet.
With Wi-Fi.
Possibly. Oh. Or it generates its own Wi-Fi.
Yes. Oh my goodness.
This is gonna be crazy. Again, defensive maneuvers, good edge guarding by Heel Life. Doesn't necessarily need to hit the down B. She just needs to do it to keep her opponent at bay.
Oh snap!
What is going to happen? See this I can't take it, Vaughn.
I can't either.
Listen. I'm going to ask you the mean question. Oh! And Frank and Bean's return the favor. Here we get into the nitty-gritty. 2-on-2. What's going to happen? They're pretty much even on damage. Who's your pick?
I got to go with my boy, Frank and Bean.
You're going to go with your boy, Frank and Bean? Well, you know what? I'm going to go with the newcomer. Because I...
The girly girl.
No, not just the girly girl. I'm going to go with who I think...
You know what? She's at one stock now. Okay, one stock... for Frank and Bean, two stock for...
Don't you change your decision now.
No.
You already said Frank and Bean.
I'm going to stick with it.
I'm going to stick with mine.
I'll stick with my guns here.
Okay? Because I'm just going by what I see.
Yes.
And if an upset and full winning against Deadpool says anything...
You're going with what you see. I'm just guessing. I'm just like rolling with dice there.
You're going to roll... Is that what you do with your life, boss?
Yes, that's what I do. You want coffee or tea? Let's roll a dice for that one.
Let's see. You get caffeine either way.
I got decaf.
Followed her right up. Oh! That dash just didn't make it.
Not far enough.
Nope. But it makes you kind of wonder.
And correct me if I'm wrong, this is 3 out of 5.
This is three out of five. No pressure. I don't want to make it.
Don't put any pressure on anybody.
I'm not even playing and I'm sweating. Why?
You're putting pressure on yourself, man.
I think I'm... Oh! Is she out? Nope, she's back in.
Nope.
Man, Frank and Bean keeping that edge. He has said that edge is mine. He made a beachhead on that thing, and he's keeping it. He's not taking no as an answer. Whoa!
Oh,
wow.
It's dangerous.
And heels back in. She does not care if he's guarding the edge. It's anybody's game right now. Oh, there we go.
Where they,
you must be dancing.
Dodged,
what
like
is going
there.
On here? And is Heel going to take the edge again? Wow. This is just volleyball.
Yeah.
This is ridiculous.
Who's going to get hit in the face first?
Oh!
Frank and Bean!
With the first match down.
First.
Four to go.
First round of the match.
Franken takes it.
Wow.
So whenever I say the name Frankenbean, I think of this stitched-up bean with bolts in its head.
Bolts on its head, yeah. But Frankenstein is technically the doctor, the scientist.
Your point?
Frankenbean monster?
Frankenstein's monster? Frankenbean's
monster?
Frankenbean's
monster.
So does that mean
someone should take that. Frankenbean's monster.
I might have an idea here. Vaughn, tell us what's going on.
All right. Second round. Oh, you're writing there?
Yeah, I am. I am. I'm doing stuff.
Okay. So, pretty aggressive so far.
Is it now?
Yeah.
How aggressive?
So aggressive, it will bake a cake. I don't know.
When I think of aggressive, I don't think of baking cakes. What's wrong with you, Vaughn?
I mean, it's an oven. It's like 400 degrees Fahrenheit or something like that. It's hot.
That sounds hot.
Well, let's stop there because we're going nowhere with that.
You're going nowhere with that. I have no idea what you're
doing. I'm dragging you with me.
Are you?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, look. Okay. So I get 2 stock. Schalk got 3 stock.
So they're 2-2?
No. No, now they are. Now they are. 2 stock.
Oh, boy.
It's an even match so far.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy and boy indeed.
Chef
Boyardee, is that what you were about to say?
I'm trying to stay away from that stuff.
Ugh.
Can no goodness.
Yes. Can of no goodness. Or goodness?
No.
Okay. But, yeah, again, sword versus sword. Very similar. But yeah. Ike's the stronger one.
Ike's the stronger one.
They both have decent range, too.
They have, I mean, Schalk.
Schalk has
out
a little bit more
range
than Ike.
Yeah. Very, very.
So,
I don't know what's going to happen.
It's kind of like an even matchup.
I am at a loss for words as far as commentating goes because I don't really know where this is going to go.
Yeah, I mean, the fresh face of Hill Life just amazes.
The fresh face?
Yes.
Is that a commercial?
Yes. It is a commercial. Fresh face. I am promoting Fresh Face. Now, we're not getting even being sponsored by.
We're not.
Because it doesn't exist. So, it does.
Maybe it does. Maybe.
Give us a call. Oh, Ike, Hugh Life.
Wow, nice.
Wow, winner of the second round.
Okay, so 1-1. Again, 3 out of 5.
Yes.
3 out of 5.
Still more to come.
I don't, maybe. I don't know what
whoever
to do.
Whoever wins the next one. We'll see.
Possibly. What if we don't see?
Well, if we don't see, that means we have technical difficulties.
This is true.
Maybe a thunderstorm or something.
We better not have technical difficulties this deep in.
Yes. Okay, now we have Hulk. Hulk.
There you go.
We have
again.
Shulk stage. Scrawny Hulk.
What do you think? It's a Franken bean.
That should be his logo.
Possibly could
be. It should be his logo. We gotta give that.
It could be. I don't know what a heel is, so I can't.
Yeah.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It's a bean. It's a bean. It's an undead bean. Not safe for consumption. Don't eat it. Don't eat it. Don't eat it.
It's dangerous.
It's a dangerous bean. Don't eat that bean. Are we good?
Okay. Awesome.
Let's get back to the match at hand. And oh, right. Oh, boy.
All right.
He lands that move like it's second nature. It doesn't. We're gonna see it at least a couple more times because they are even right now. Winner right now still doesn't take it because it's 3 out of 5.
Right.
And if instincts,
animal instincts or instincts, aminal instincts.
Aminal. Okay.
There you go.
And Hio has returned the favor. See, this is the back and forth.
Yeah.
Frankenbean kicks her out. Hio returns the favor right back.
Right.
Okay. Look at how it's necessary at times to just go ahead and cut the combo short.
Yeah.
Both of these.
Oh, come on.
Come on. What's going on here? Is she? Ooh, she was going for the counter as an edge guard. Whoa! That is unorthodox. Smash up. Nice choice. Definitely did not see that coming.
No.
Nope.
Hit him pretty far, too.
Okay.
Nope. Okay.
And if you could just hear the clacking of the remote of the controllers right now. These guys.
Oh! Up smash! By Frankenbean.
Going into the sequel.
Taking out 1 stock from Hill Life. This is good.
This is good. But here's the thing, though. With all this slashing going on, why are there still weeds?
Hey. Wait a minute. Those weeds are unstoppable.
They are.
Like
maybe they should
steel,
be the next contenders.
Titanium or diamonds?
Or adamantium.
Or that. Vibranium.
Vibranium? The anti-metal?
Yes.
Antarctic vibranium?
It's Captain America's shield.
they're just going at it.
Yeah.
I want to commentate. I want to see what's going on. But the...
Okay.
We are 1-1.
But still, good amount of damage on
Ike has a... I mean, Heal Life does not have the damage advantage right now. What? Frankenbean could take it. Unless, of course, she lands a heavy blow.
Somehow, yeah.
It's a possibility.
Yeah.
She has measured and metered distance and frame. No, that was on purpose. Oof. That's totally a tactic to bait.
Is that a bait or something?
Yeah, that is definitely a bait. And he has returned the favor trying to bait as well.
Ooh.
Oh, and the throw.
Not the right timing there.
No, that's the right timing. The question is what the follow-up will be. Oh, wow, just out of range. What a lie. What... And look at that. See, again, with that skill, switching right to the appropriate power sign that he needs in order to continue the fight. Whoa! Is he out? Man, look at this. He's at 80 damage already. This is crazy.
This is nuts. Very skillful. Oh! Wow!
And it is 2-1. Heal Life with the advantage right now.
Heal Life at 2 rounds.
I'm gonna take my eyes
that
and
is
throw them this
nuts.
Way.
All right.
I don't.
Oh, clear plane.
Just right back. They're keeping the momentum going. They're not gonna rest. Frankenbean has something to prove.
There's no rest for the restless.
Yes.
They keep going until they finish this.
I don't even know how to follow up with that last
That's really
I couldn't wow. I stopped being able to follow up.
First Deadpool?
After Deadpool.
Speechless.
He was speechless too.
Yeah.
So I have a very, very succinct feeling that come November things are going to be insane
right.
during the Ruben Langdon tournament. There's not going to be any shortage of ridiculousness that we'll be talking about probably for the next year.
Right.
Something stupid like that.
And this is going to be first for Capcom, right? Street Fighter?
Street Fighter, yes.
Street Fighter 4?
4 for the time
Ultra?
Being. We don't know if it's going to be Ultra or Omega yet.
Okay. It's going to be sure. Street Fighter 4.
Okay, we're going to need to talk to Jovette about that and find out what he's going to finalize yeah. on.
But don't miss it. That's going to be an exciting...
If you miss it, it's your bad.
And by the way...
BTW
might be a live feed as well.
Ooh. Oh!
What?
And Shulk, took
first one to go out.
Yep. He found a diamond in the cloud.
Yeah. Bling bling.
Bling bling. Oh, and is nope. Is Heal Life gonna take a dip?
Oh my!
Wow! No!
Tighten up, Frankenbean.
You can do this.
Oh
you can do
gosh.
This. Breathe deep, buddy. Give it everything you got.
Got a big hill to climb there. Wow. This is craziness, folks.
This is. I am I'm at a loss for words. This shouldn't be happening, but it is.
It's out of nowhere.
From nowheresville. This reminds me of when Mulax came in
yes.
during his first tournament and just, you know, said, you. And then right. Sensei, same thing.
Yeah.
These competitors from nowhere.
Sensei was his first match from last month.
Yeah, it was the previous.
He beat Vagrant.
Yes, he did.
That was an upset.
With Mario, that Mario was crazy.
Right.
That Mario, he had, I don't know.
Fire-looking Mario.
The fire.
Yeah, the
Mario.
White.
Oh boy! Oh! Excellent! 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 And she takes it. And she takes it. Wow. That is 3-5. The win for Heal Life. And I don't know, I think everybody maybe got a little bit excited there. We'll be back.
Yeah, we have to like collect
compose ourselves.
Okay.
We'll
be right back.
Eight.
Then
repeat after me.
Finals of the finals.
It's a final final.
This is the last battle. The last boss.
The final boss?
Yes, this is a final boss.
This is a Capcom boss, because if Fish loses, she has to fight him again.
Guess what?
In his final form.
It is Hyolife versus
Fish.
Fish. And this came from the very first match.
We just had a complete circle. A complete circle. We started this way, and we're ending it this way.
That's crazy.
That's insanity.
So, we got Fish, undefeated in this tournament.
Undefeated.
Hyolife, creating like all these upsets around this tournament.
I don't, why do we have so many papers?
She only lost once, and that's against Fish.
Yes.
Let's see if Hyolife can redeem herself.
She lost. However, let's keep in mind that she lost her last stock because she found a shiny piece of candy at the bottom of the stage.
Yes. It bit her back.
Okay.
That shiny piece of candy.
I'm gonna bet her. I'm gonna tell you what that shiny piece of candy was.
What is it?
It was a lollipop.
Wow.
Yeah. It was. I bet you don't even know what flavor.
Watermelon.
Yes! The only flavor worth dying for. Anyways, back to the match.
Okay. We have Sheik versus Ike.
Wait. He picked Sheik?
Fish picked Sheik.
Okay. Maybe he's trying to throw Hyolife off of her game?
Yeah. You got going speed versus power.
Speed versus power. I hope you save room for lunch. I have no idea what's going to happen right now. I'm just...
Sheesh. This is a really interesting tournament.
I want to watch more than I want to say anything. It's just driving me bananas because...
You just want to focus on the match because this is crazy. This is bananas.
We need to just get into a headspace here for a moment. Whoa, the recovery. And okay. We're going back to the same thing. She's basically driving a Hummer and she's treating it like it's a friggin' Fiat.
Ferrari.
Or a Ferrari if you want.
Sure.
Because she's matching speed with Fish on it. I don't even know.
It's like,
wow.
Okay.
And the thing is that we have to keep in mind, swinging for the fences, basically, if she gets a good hit.
Oh!
My point has been proved. There you go.
It's like a Humvee racing against a Ferrari.
I don't even know.
But the Humvee's beating the Ferrari.
Exactly. It makes no sense.
We'll see. This is still the beginning of the match.
It's like they put... Ooh,
wow.
And there we go.
Okay.
2-2. This is where it gets hectic. Keep in mind that if Hyo takes this match, she has to beat Fish again.
Right.
If Fish takes the match, he takes the tournament. It's his first place.
Right.
I've heard the prizes today are pretty darn beast.
Yes. And that's a pretty big hill for Hyolife to climb on that one.
I don't really.
She has to go through double elimination against Fish.
Double elimination against Fish, but here's the thing: it's more endurance than anything else.
Yeah.
It's keeping consistency. I wouldn't necessarily say it's a hill because at the end of the day, if somebody throws a brick at you, you either dodge it or you catch it.
By the way, you got water right next to you. Sparkle.
Mm. You think? Sparkling water.
Spot.
Have some.
All right.
Now, I want to keep everybody informed that right now, as it stands, this has probably been the only time that we've had a first-time competitor vying for first place. Mulax came in. Actually,
Mulax was number three in his first match.
Right.
For his first tournament.
Yeah, but I mean... With the exception of someone not really known, is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Because Mulax came in, and I think Mulax solidified a fourth place decision when he came in. And when Sensei came in, what did he get, third place?
Yeah, that's right. Sensei came in third place.
Exactly. So we're looking at a competitor. We've got a lot of firsts today. First with Hyolife vying for first place.
Right.
We've got somebody that actually was able to utilize a Mii in combat and win, which was with Alfie. And now that I'm being informed here, Poltergust was in our early competitions a competitor that came in for the first time and actually took first place, right? Yeah, he took first place.
Wow.
Fortunately, he hasn't come back yet, so maybe we'll see.
Was it only once?
Yeah, only once.
Wow.
He only graced us with his presence once. It's like that mysterious stranger.
Where are you, Puerto Gusto?
Where are you, Puerto Gusto? I am Boots. In Boots. Because, you know, he was... Never mind.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
Oh. Hey, Chica. Oh, okay.
So look at this.
Fish at one stock.
And yeah. Again, now, they're returning the favor. We're at 41. I guess for Fish at 41%. And Hio at 10, there's a
Fish
difference.
Just has to pick some damage against Ike.
Honest, and there we go. Already landed a combo and passed 50%. This fight, it's all going to depend on the up smash.
Right.
It's going to be an up smash.
Right.
I'm going to call it now. Not a meteor strike, an up smash. And if I'm wrong, so what? And I see that Fish is playing it safe.
Yeah.
Projectile dash in.
I mean, Ike's such a strong character. He can just knock you off very easily.
Yeah, but the thing about it is, what's crazy is the recovery animation that's involved in a character like Ike.
Yeah.
This is why I use the analogy that she's basically driving an 18-wheeler. Notice every time the car gets bigger.
Yeah.
Driving the 18-wheeler down a two-lane highway. And BAM! Okay. And she takes it. What'd I tell you?
Wow.
It was a forward smash. That's fine. He sailed up.
Smashed him out of the screen.
Smashed him out of the screen.
Wow.
This is 3 out of 5.
Where are we right now? Was that the second round? Or no, this is the first round.
This is 3 out of 5. Potentially speaking,
how many runs are we in right now?
This is the first.
This is the first. Okay.
This is gonna be crazy.
So Heal Life got the first round.
Heal Life has taken the first fight. She needs to take 2 more.
Wow.
Now the competitors have already been informed. No, no, no throwing chairs.
Yep.
No smashing each other.
No scratching.
Over the head. Nothing.
No eye gouging.
Smashing is only allowed on screen.
No table flipping.
Now, once the tournament is over, we have no control over the smashing that might take place.
We just have to leave right away.
Yes. I'm leaving in your car, right?
Yes.
Okay, good.
I'll be driving away. Let's get out of here. Our lives matter.
Our lives matter.
All right.
And we're going
Another Animal Crossing stage.
Okay. There's going to be a change in strategy, I'm quite sure, either towards the end of this match or probably in the third match that's coming up. And I'm going to say that the change is going to come from Fish. Because as it stands, the strategy that Heal Life is employing is working out and has been working out for every single opponent she's faced so far. Do you know what the strategy is?
What is the strategy?
Unpredictability.
For Heal Life?
Yes. That has worked to her advantage 9 times out of 10. There's a lot of baiting going on in her style. A lot of high-low mix-ups.
Well, if you think about it, a lot of the regulars are kind of familiar with each other. Each other's characters as well.
But that's the thing. It's the
Heal Life just came out. This comes out of nowhere. Ike.
Out of nowhere?
No, no one's
with? Ike.
With Ike. Except for Peel. He plays with Ike.
Oh, and there we go. The up smash again.
Nice.
Up Doom.
Nice.
It's a counter. And it's and there, that is how you play a counter character, a counter move. Counter move has to be, it's kind of like playing Third Strike, if you're familiar with Third Strike and the parrying system. Parrying system rewards you for parrying as close to the moment that your opponent's attack reaches the hitbox.
Oh.
And bam! We're at 2-2.
There's Fish's answer right there.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Nice.
All right, here we go. See? There we go. Change of strategy. He's going right for the throws. You see that?
Right for the jugular.
He has to. He has to. You gotta match damage. And the only way for Sheik to match damage is with throws and with smashes. Combination attacks are only going to bait the opponent away.
Right.
Now, again, she's not going to change her strategy.
Yep.
She doesn't need to.
I mean, she's been successful in her strategy.
No, the strategy is going to pay off until the end. Fish is probably going to have to go ahead and adapt to the strategy.
She just has to dodge his attacks.
Not even. She's really dodging the attacks.
Just keep his distance.
Yeah, she's just basically dancing around, which again makes no sense. You have to take it. It's kind of like, look at that. Look at that bait.
Yep.
Look at that perfect bait. It's crazy. It's kind of like watching the Big Show doing backflips in a fight against Rob Van Dam.
Yes.
Makes no sense.
Wow.
How's that for your analogy?
No, that's great. That's a great analogy. Big Show doing the,
The Van Daminator?
Van Daminator.
Yeah. And Rob going, well, but I'm...
Rolling Thunder.
But I'm the whole show. No, bro. I'm the Big Show.
I'm the Big Show.
Yeah, but that's not going to happen ever.
Yeah, this is Super Smash Brothers.
This is Super... Anything can happen.
Yes. So I get 105%.
Whoa, that was close. That was close.
She got 101% damage.
You gotta think about the fact that there's a little... The Meteor Smash paid off. He is at a 2-1 advantage. Again, all Ike really has to do is sneeze. And he's out of the ring.
Yeah. Look at that. Sheik's a very light character, so it's not going to take much to knock her out.
And
there you go.
Yep, there we go. Told you.
That platform strategy. Oh, my goodness.
Loser
took you closer to the
loser pick stages, so this has been Fish's choice.
Yeah.
I'm guessing maybe with the unpredictability of the movement on a slow character, it might work towards his advantage. Being that Sheik is a very aerial character, there's a lot of things going into the choice here.
Right.
I don't know exactly what's going to happen.
You don't want Ike to counter your moves as well.
He can't counter a projectile.
Well, not a projectile.
You know, and he's fully charging it. In most cases, anyway.
Fish is doing a good job so far, keeping his distance.
He's doing an excellent job. Like I said, we're already aware of. This is what, his sixth match? Can we confirm?
Yeah, I think it was sixth match.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I lost count. Or is it 5?
It's 1.
Oh,
two,
that's right. It is 6. It is 6.
3. Anyways, count them out, but I think it's 6
or
5.
Six. It's 6.
It's 6.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it is getting down to the final wire. Fish could take the match right now if he lands just the right hit. He'll need to go with Sheik's up A. Oh, or her down A.
Right.
To land the big damage. Or he could go for the aerial spike. Oh, nope, and he's going with the forward smash. He might land it. Nope. Okay, she's able to escape that. Ooh.
In the air? Nope.
Not getting it. She's going for the bait. She's going for the bait.
Oh,
is she going to get it? Nice combination.
Nice. Oh! Wow!
And it is two out of five. If she wins the next one, we're going into the second elimination.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
Looking good for heel life.
It's good. It's looking good for heel life. We're not going to, you know, she's basically pulling the lever on the jackpot.
Yes.
Albeit, she's doing it with a sledgehammer.
Right. Okay, we're going to take a quick break, so we'll be right back, and we're going to continue with this match.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, we're back.
This is the face of flabbergastedness. 2 out of 5, heel life. Barrel, I won't say barreling through. Fish is definitely putting up a fight. We are getting the same type of matches. We're getting an even combination, 1-1, 2-2, you know. I don't know what's gonna happen.
So what's gonna happen is if Heel Life wins this next round, she wins this match, and we move on.
She wins this set.
Yes.
She will win this set.
We start with the next elimination.
Uh huh.
So she's banging it so far. She looks like she has a good chance of taking this.
And there we go. What did I tell you? We got to change. It was going to take place either in the second or third match, and it's come in the form of a different character.
Pikachu.
Pikachu is going to present all sorts of problems for Ike. I don't know if it will be sufficient to give Fish the win.
Number 4, by the way. Pikachu.
Number 4. But Sheik was number 2.
Yes.
We go back to the tier list again. It's all going to be about the strategy. That we can think of right off the bat, Pikachu is going to present the problem in size and speed.
Right.
Way faster than Sheik, and, you know, lends itself a little bit more to unpredictability.
Right.
Now, how Ike is going to deal with that, how Hiyo's going to go ahead and deal with that, I don't really know.
Right.
Oh, stronger projectile attacks also, but I don't see Fish utilizing those just yet.
Right.
I think the strategy is going to be get in, strike, and throw.
Right.
Get in, strike, and throw. Oh, and I spoke too soon. Oh. My specialty.
Making the stage dangerous when you're trying to recover there.
Oh, see, there we go.
Oh.
Oh! Oh, nice combination.
It's a deadly combo there.
Yeah, it is. And that's how you can tell an advanced Pikachu player from a novice. An advanced Pikachu player will set up for this Thunderstrike.
Right.
They'll do it. Other ones will just throw it at random.
Oh! Okay.
Ooh! And Ike is tasting Plasma.
First out to heal life.
Yep. But she's not going to be far behind at 96.
Oh!
Excellent counter with down B. Nice. It finally lands.
What power?
What power? I quit you whining.
This is good.
This is very good. I'm wondering at this point, though, if that's... Because keep in mind, that's always going to be heal life's defense. It's going to be the down B volcanic smash. And it's going to be... Keep in mind that with Pikachu, though, Pikachu does have great range, very light, can be floaty in some instances.
Right.
His third jump leaves to split-second decisions.
Right.
So I don't think that necessarily Fish, at the vantage point where he was, really had a choice on how to get back into the ring.
Right.
It was just perfect timing on her part.
Right.
So let's see. And again, the choice is for a multi-tiered stage, which again does benefit Pikachu.
Right.
I don't really know how this is going to go down. This is insanity. Not going to really be able to wear down Ike's shield, which is why he's not going for the continuous attack.
Right.
Smart on Fish's part.
Right.
Where at, Heal Life could really play the part
nice.
To smash Pikachu's shield.
Right.
I don't think she's going to go for it because I don't think Fish is going to allow something like that.
Right.
But we're going to see.
You shall see.
Yeah. I'm seeing a lot of attacks. Wow. The throw out of nowhere. Okay, bait and switch. Up A.
Danger spot, okay.
And again, here's the thing.
Smash!
Forward A smash.
Pikachu smash. Oh, wow.
Okay, so he's... Oh, come on. What's he gonna do? Okay, and he's playing it safe the second time around, not jumping
into
the
ring.
Now, it may be up to Heal Life to go ahead and actually change up strategies just slightly on the edge guard.
Right.
However, down B is not a bad choice. Ooh!
There we go. Wow.
And again...
It's back and forth.
It is back and forth. Again, Pikachu just having to do a little bit more work to go ahead and get rid of Ike.
Right.
Ike just the opposite. Okay?
He just has to take it. You know,
yeah. Once he's got Pikachu at 90 plus life... It's guaranteed sailing.
Right. That power is no joke for Mike.
No, not at all. Never has been.
Never ever.
Never ever. Trounced Pikachu. Here we go. Ooh. Nice
Peck
setup.
Some damage there.
Yeah. Neutral A. Always a pain. Yeah. Ooh, and a grab. Really thought Fish had that grab. Ooh. Nope, not getting it. Shocking.
Shocking revelation.
Is she going for the bait? Nope, not going for the bait. Going right onto the stage.
Oh.
And they're playing those close quarters. And again, you'll notice that the strategy is not really changing because it doesn't have to. It's going to be adaptability.
Right.
There's slight modifications that I'm seeing here in what Hiyo is doing to adjust and compensate for such a small character.
This is a really close matchup. Okay. With the amount of damage a Pikachu has...
I'm so excited I'm coughing.
The amount of damage a Pikachu has... Fish is in a dangerous situation right now.
Is he going to sail? Oh, wow! That was a big risk. Will it pay off?
Nope,
he did not land.
Didn't
the
hit him with
hit.
Thunder.
If he hits with Thunder, that's it.
Yeah, that
it's
is
game
it.
Over. It's anybody's
still,
game
still
at this
alive.
Point. Keep in mind, Hiyo could take
it. Oh!
Wow!
We had a repeat
of the first match, but keep in mind it doesn't matter. This only means it's 1-2, best 3 out of 5. Fish still has to win two more times.
Moving on to the next round for this one. Still going.
I don't.
Still, it's good. Don't want to slip like that again.
No, you don't. But that's not a slip. That's a dive.
That was a suicide.
That was. That time it was for gummy bears.
Gummy bears.
gummy bears, sprinkles.
Ooh, piece of candy.
Ooh, another piece of candy. Anyways, are we going back to loser chooses? Ooh, an interesting choice. I wonder why this would be a choice. Mm. Oh, okay, we're going with an Omega stage. This is where Ike is going to thrive.
Okay.
An open playing field for him to do mayhem.
Right.
Ooh, and we're already
no
starting.
No platforms, just straight up field.
And it looks like Fish is trying to tack on damage as quickly as possible and take the first down.
Yeah.
Gonna try very, very hard.
That's actually a smart strategy from Kill Life, taking the stage, because you don't have any other platforms that Pikachu can make into
correct.
Turn into a hazard.
The last thing you want to do is give a character with a strong aerial game more, you know, footholds.
Right.
Sure, it does hamper Pikachu from utilizing Thunderstrike more effectively, and that is something that she's opened up to now that they've picked an Omega stage.
Right.
But it's not as bad as giving him more vantage points.
All right.
Because the tighter the spaces, the more it works to Pikachu's benefit.
Yeah.
Whereas you can create the sufficient enough space to be in a 2-0 range to just go ahead and go big swings. And interestingly enough, Fish is taking advantage of the open space.
He's actually doing better with Pikachu against Ike.
I actually think so. Maybe the straightforward approach is a little bit more to his advantage.
Yeah.
Or maybe he's just taking advantage of... little subtleties. Nice.
Oh,
nice.
Nice
down air. And if he hits, all she has to do is whack him once.
Oh,
and
like that.
Yep,
well,
yep.
No, not yet.
Nope. Oh, there we go. That was the polish.
Big swing.
That was the polish. And here we go. What's going to happen now is we're going to see a little bit more setup. It's gonna be chip.
Try to chip him.
Well, yeah,
but,
gonna try.
You know, Pikachu kept doing the Thunder Shock, but now Heal Life started jumping over the Thunder Shock.
Well, the interesting thing is she could always go for the aerial sword swing and actually cancel the Thunder Shock.
Right.
But the interesting thing is that Fish, showing again his advanced expertise of the character.
Oh, look at that!
Yeah.
Oh, that.
That's
that
just crazy.
That's.
Keeping
stunned him while trying to recover the Thunder Shock.
Nice. And the recovery for the stun. Is she out?
Whoa.
Yes! She is out. She just punched Locky 2 in the face.
Alright.
Because Locky 2's a jerk. So he's on his cloud just judging. It's like, hey, you want the one up? You want the one up? Well, no.
Not for you.
You can have a spine. Jerk. Anyways. And what's going to happen here is we're going to see some subtle changes now. We're going to see...
Yes, we did see some subtle changes.
No, we're going to see even more.
Even more?
Well, yeah, I think that Fish is going to go for the square. And I want to go ahead and keep that low because I don't want to keep, you know...
Yeah,
I'm pretty close. But you're going to see exactly what I'm talking about in just a moment. It's going for the throw. And here we go. Ooh, and she stopped that. She stopped that nonsense.
Oh!
She put a halt to that nonsense right away.
Nice.
Will he change or will he go for the vertical approach?
Nope.
You know that your opponent is very dangerous when you've got to change so much.
Yeah.
A change in character is one of, you know, you got to be tactical about it.
Right.
Because if
you also got to know him, too. You got to know the character that you're playing against.
It's not that. It's just the message that it conveys to your opponent.
You think?
Absolutely. Because if you're changing, keep in mind people have, most players will have, very rarely will you encounter a player who has just one main. It's just not beneficial.
A good player.
A very good player will have 3 to 4 characters. Enough to vary. And the really good players are going to be, you know, it all comes down to psychology on what they're going to consider being their best. Does he got it?
Nope.
Are they going to be even?
Oh my goodness.
I don't even know. This is down. If he takes this, okay, she's racking up damage. It could go any
way. You don't
want
to be in that position. Okay.
Okay, wow. Went for the counter. That could have been scary right there for Fish.
Yeah.
But man, the pressure's on and she's just adapting like tofu.
Those thundershocks are annoying, but effective.
Maybe she should change her name to Tofu Life.
Tofu Life?
Tofu Life, yeah, man. Tofu takes on the flavor of whatever you put in front of it. Okay, how's he gonna edge guard?
Yeah.
Oh, trying to capitalize and see if she'll slip up. Will it happen? Nope.
That was very close, by the way.
It was very close. Oh, and here we go. We are 2-2. Winner of the next battle
will be the winner of this match.
Will be the winner of this set. Keep in mind that if Fish takes it, it's his. He's first
done
place.
Deal.
It's done deal.
So last chance for Heal Life.
Last chance for Heal Life.
We're going to take a quick
break,
by the way.
We're going to take a quick break. My eyes are going to fall out.
So we'll be right back.
I'm transfixed.
Yeah.
I can't kick my eyes off the screen. I can see through the microphone.
I can see through the camera. All right.
Whenever you guys are ready.
All right, are you guys ready? Do you got things?
You want to take a break for a minute or two?
I talk in the accent because I can. Are you ready?
All right. Back again.
I can't look.
Wow.
I'm only going to peek with one
Very
eye.
Very close.
Just one. Okay, never mind. I'm just going to use both.
All right.
Okay, Fish is sticking with Pikachu. He's had success with Pikachu. Again, I think it's just due to better projectile and a smaller character.
Right.
Okay, smaller hitbox, a little bit more work for Heolife. Heolife always starts out strong. Look at this. This is ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's play like this that makes me just want to grab a controller and
smash. Yes.
No, not smash it to the ground. It makes me want to
smash
play
in
smash.
The air.
Just, I don't know. No, I don't want to smash the controller. I want to play smash watching this
kind
of advanced.
Smash.
Yes,
okay.
Exactly.
I thought you wanted to break something.
No.
Okay.
No. And, okay, she's playing the aerial game and playing it. Oh! And Pikachu is out.
First out.
Pikachu.
From Heolife.
Yep. Apparently there's no floating islands in that vicinity.
No platforms there.
No platforms.
Just straight up.
Although I'm confused, the world of the majority of these Nintendo characters, where is this anti-gravity dirt? Look at this
thing. Anti-gravity island?
Who builds a temple and then has it float up in the air and goes, oh, there goes my work.
And it's all abandoned.
It's like I started building pesky anti-gravity dirt, took my columns. It's terrible. Who comes up with this stuff?
Fire them.
They're all fired.
Yeah.
Including Da Vinci.
Yeah.
What's Da Vinci have to do with this? Nothing. Nothing. Anyways, I'm sorry. I digress. Or I digressed.
You digress? Digress?
Digress? Is that a new
digress.
Pokemon?
I don't know.
Anyways, going back, we are 2-3. The advantage is going to Heolife. Again, even though she's at 100, it's a little bit more work for Pikachu. Fish lands a down A, or at least 5 or 4 strikes with a neutral attack, he's got this.
My goodness.
Going for the up A, and it's not having any success. I think Hio is seeing that a mile away.
Right.
Especially with the speed of her counter.
Right.
That's the other. Whoop! And the exchange. Right. There we go. He nailed it.
That's still Pikachu at 99% damage.
Yeah. Pikachu.
That's a good amount of damage on Pikachu right now.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Yeah.
Pikachu
is
taking a
trip. See what
I'm
talking about?
Come sail away with me.
Pikachu didn't faint yet.
He can. I'm not really sure what's going to happen right now.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Now, this is smart. Okay?
Right.
Because keep in mind that if he just does it neutrally, it's just going to travel.
Disrupt your opponent's movements.
Exactly.
Yes.
Stagger. Oh boy, that forward A strike is nasty.
Yeah.
It stuns and it does big damage. Ooh, he's taking big risks.
Oh.
He's really trying hard here.
Okay, took a good chunk of damage on Pikachu.
Yeah, he did, but look at that. Ooh boy, follow-up strike to a paralyzer. Where's he going to now? Look at that. As you can see, he creates the space and he builds that false sense of security. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's building.
It leaves a little bit of opening on you.
Yeah, exactly. But
you're
remember
in the air,
that
you can take advantage of it.
Yeah, but Pikachu can close that gap in an instant. Whoa, down A. Nice. Landed a down A, and look at how quickly he climbed on damage. That's got to be the most frustrating thing about
down
being...
A.
Yeah, down A. What?
Down A.
What did I say?
Oh.
Is that wrong?
Yes, it is.
The sweeping attack electricity thingamajiggy. All right? How's that for technical? Concise indeed.
Or super duper.
The super duper.
Super duper mega humongous.
Pikachu breakdance spin. Anyways, moving forward, or moving up in this case.
Or forward, or
Pikachu
somewhere.
Is about to fly out of there like produce.
Yes. Produce?
Produce, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well, he reminds me of a banana with fur.
With cherries on it.
With cherries? Oh, the cheeks.
Rosy cheeks.
Anyways.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Okay.
Okay.
Nope.
Pikachu
nope.
in a danger
nope.
spot right now.
Very big
103%
danger zone.
Damage.
There is no way for Pikachu to really displace the opponent like maybe like Bowser or maybe like Captain Falcon or anything like that. He's got to build up the damage and he's got to do a big attack to go ahead and get her out of there. I have a very funny feeling that we'll be seeing a reset. I have this inkling feeling that we're going to see.
No! Still alive!
Oh, and doing it right at the last second just so he doesn't get smashed with that edge guard.
It's one swing. That's going to be...
This is a samurai feud. And what's going to happen here? Ooh, tension.
Doing a good job. Pikachu.
And what
there.
Is he going to do? He's taking a big nice. Risk. Is he going to land it?
Nice.
Is he going to hit it?
Oh!
What did I tell you? What did I tell you?
Oh!
And it resets, or it goes into the... it does the thing with the stuff.
It does the jiggamy jigger.
And now we're gonna have to go into a brand new set. This set is done. The winner is Heolife on this set. And, wow, another 3 out of 5.
Yeah. Okay. So, we'll take a break again, so we can recover. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Okay, guess what?
Chicken butt?
Yes.
Exactly. Why?
Chicken fly.
No, they can't.
Okay,
chicken
very...
ant? Ah, we're done. Look, I'm
done, son.
Listen to me. This is... Okay. What is the craziest thing you've ever seen in competitive sports?
Can I do MMA?
You can do MMA.
Yeah, a lot of Ronda Rousey.
Okay. No. Probably the craziest thing is watching the comeback kid get beaten up for about 3 rounds.
You guys can
and then
start,
taking,
by the way.
You
can
go. You don't have to listen to us. We're going
to
banter regardless of which.
Stop going off the Red Sox. Coming back.
We're not going off topic. Be quiet, Tribal. This kid will do anything.
Shut up, Tribal.
Shut up. Down smash A, up BW. Anyways.
Zero Suit Samus is back.
It's like watching somebody go take a beating for about 3 rounds and at the last minute take the win.
Yes.
And this is exactly what's going on. We have the first set is done. Heolife has taken it and for the first time provided Fish with his first loss
ever in this tournament.
Ever in this tournament. He's encountered his first loss. It still means that she has to do the impossible twice.
Twice.
Well, the possible impossible.
Possible, possible.
Or the down smash impossible.
Right.
Is that possible?
It is possible.
It is.
Only in Capca.
Only in a Capca tournament. And I see here that Fish has decided to go back to his roots. I said roots. You like
roots.
That? The roots. And he's picked Zero Suit Samus. No Sheik, no Pikachu.
No Sheik or Pikachu.
Yeah, I wanted to make that.
Yeah,
rhyme.
That's very clever. That's very smart.
it's very
sneaky.
It's very stupid. Anyways.
All right.
Listen, I'm at my wit's end here because I want someone to
tournament.
Win. I want someone to win, but I can't make up my mind.
Yes.
I can't make up my mind.
Thanks,
so,
Fish.
No. I'll say nothing. How's that?
I'll take that as a no.
There must be a winner and a not winner. Your call?
I can't say anything either.
We are on the last set.
Yes. We're a little bit drained right now because all this is so intense.
Listen to this. This is one slash for fish, one W for heel life. No, I'm not giving the keys to my ride to the winner.
I should have taken that from you.
No. No.
Is that a distraction? You take your keys.
Take the keys!
Alright.
I just want to sit back and spectate, but I can't. I'm compelled
to. We gotta do our jobs, Manny.
Look, Zero Suit Samus might take a trip.
Or be trippy.
No, she's going to take a trip. That stock is going. How? Not really sure
yet.
Some
way, somehow.
But he's gonna need to build
damage.
Sooner
or later.
He needs to build damage past 80% to have a viable chance once his stock goes down by one. Mm-hmm. He's gonna need it. Okay? And
there you go.
Happen. He's at 70. So, still, it's a good damage base.
Yeah.
The problem is combos. The problem is back A. The problem is down A. The problem is a lot
up
of different
A
things.
Well.
Up A is not going to be a big issue here, especially among so many platforms. So.
Well, I mean, you go past the platforms, though.
And no, it doesn't really matter.
No?
The recovery on an attack like that is...
Yes.
Yep, there we go. And is she out? Nope. Back in. Will she go for the bait? Nope, she landed right on the platform.
Jumped on her head.
Oh, nice. Nice. And there's going to be a lot. They're going to play to their strengths at this point. He is going to go for a lot of finesse. He's going to try to get around... Basically, just stay away from whatever Ike is facing.
You don't want to get stunned.
You don't, but again, the thing about it is Zero Suit Samus has the ability to cross up quite a lot.
Yeah.
You know, I don't really know if there's going to be a character that's more suited to it than Zero Suit. Probably Sheik. But, you know, she's just a little bit more built for it.
Right.
But you still have to watch out for... Smash on both sides. You still got to watch out for counters. You still got to watch out for ether.
You know, that's a good example right there. Stun.
And there we go. And Fish takes it.
All right. Takes the first.
And dominates the first encounter with a 2-0 stock.
Zero Suit Samus.
Showing again why Zero Suit is his main.
Right.
Now, maybe he was just building up a little bit of confidence in
based
the previous
on his inspiration.
Set. Based on his inspiration. I think
gamer.
He feels inspired right now.
Yep.
He might be.
For himself.
I feel inspired.
Are you planning to compete soon? Eh?
Huh?
Are you planning to compete soon?
No.
This one's
no. I have Anytime a very I have a very recreational appreciation for Smash Bros.
Look at this over here.
But I don't know. I stick
it's
to
a fun game.
It is a fun game. It is a fun game and I love watching it and I love watching high level play.
Yeah.
But my games of choice have always been 3D. I don't
3D?
Know why. 3D has always been my realm.
Yeah.
I'm very capable as long as I can strafe and sidestep. It's, I don't know.
Because
I've tried Street Fighter for years. I've tried Mortal Kombat.
So Soul Calibur up your alley?
Definitely.
Okay.
I'm a very, I'm not going to toot my own horn.
Maybe,
I'm good at it.
Maybe sooner or later we'll be calling out Soul Calibur games.
But
maybe.
Then again, maybe I might compete. I don't know. But it's been a hot minute.
Yeah.
I would have to play consecutively a lot. But anyways, that's not the point. We're not the important people right now. It's these guys. It's Heel Life. It's Fish. It's the beating
of a lifetime.
Read my mind.
Yes.
Nice job there, buddy.
Yeah.
Ooh, going for the paralyzer. I really didn't think he was going to land it there. Tricky, tricky. But he couldn't capitalize on it. And again, we see the projectile with the follow-up. Look at how quickly he closes the gap. That is the whole thing. Closing that gap and Fish loves to do that.
Right.
Give you with a wall of different attacks, and then BAM! There we go, out. Takes the first stock. Good job.
Good job. Zero Suit Samus at 38%. Still needs some work to do.
And there's a big change. Again, we don't really know what's going on through the competitor's head unless we really speak with them. But I'm thinking that he was just warming up to the idea of being able to fight. We do know that when we spoke with Fish earlier, he felt, you know, he felt a little bad. He felt, he really felt the match could have gone a different way. Felt bad that she fell. And now we're getting a taste of what really would have happened earlier today had that fight gone on. And boom.
Blasting off again.
Yep, she's going over the chocolate planes. Yeah, that's
don't
directly.
Don't want to get stunned like that.
That's directly open. North of Donut Plains. Yeah. So.
It looks delicious, by the way.
It is. I think that
it looks
you
like
can,
you can peel it and there's chocolate.
Yeah, well, I mean, I don't know what Shigeto's
inspiration. There's apples or whatever those are.
Shigeto's inspiration was definitely a large quantity of pastries and sweets when he made Super Mario World. Mm,
interesting.
Or one of the directors.
Sounds delicious.
It is. Nice. But then I wonder, it's hot. If you have a place called Donut Plains or Chocolate Valley or whatever, wouldn't it melt?
Good? You could.
And there we go. Ike Tay screen.
Oh.
We're at a 2-1. And what? And
even.
They are now even.
Okay.
Here we go. Even Steven. Let's see who takes it.
Is it going to be fish or is it going to be heel life?
Again.
If it's fish, that's it.
If it's heel life, that's heel it life. Too. If she wins, she takes first place. That's what's on the line right now. There's a lot on the line. And I think fish wants it just as bad as she does. He wants the win. He's going for the W, no doubt about it.
Yeah.
And he's pulling out all the stops. And nice. Nice. Good cancel. Ooh.
Wow.
Stacking damage.
Oh
yeah. Wow. This is some high-level gameplay. This is nice. Fish takes the second win. If he takes the very next win, that's it.
Yep.
That's it.
Gotta hustle.
End of the eighth.
Again, this is 3 out of 5.
Correct.
Best 3 out of 5.
If she wins, she still has to produce another win. And then we go into nail-biting territory.
Yes. Or crying territory.
I'm holding back my tears.
Fainting territory.
I think I forgot how to breathe earlier. But I'm good.
Really?
I'm good. We need to take a second, right?
Can we take a second? Maybe we'll take a break for a little bit and we'll come back.
Yeah.
Okay.
And we are back. We're a couple seconds into the third match. Man, I mean, it's just a repeat of what's been fantastic so far, just more of the same.
It's very, very close.
I don't know. These guys are beating each other up. I would almost think that the beating is so severe that the fruit should be falling off the back of the trees.
Like in back. Should be earthquakes and thunderstorms.
There's already earthquakes. There's broken...
Like broken land or something?
Broken land.
There was an earthquake.
That bullet bill keeps circling around, but he's not going anywhere near there. He's just looking for Mario. He's like, I'm going to take it easy. Nice dodge. Right through the projectiles. It's interesting that you would think with a character like that, you don't really want to close ground so quickly, but he was a very aggressive player. Very calculated.
Right.
Fish a little bit more risky. More of a close the gap kind of guy. And interestingly enough, the reach on Zero Suit Samus' throw is excellent, but if whiffed, leaves you very vulnerable. Oh! No! Whoa. See? There we go. Wow, I'm nice. Telling you, man. It's just... And okay, the recovery nice. Came through. Can he make it back in? Yes, he does, and with style.
Other side of the stage.
Yeah, I mean, she's going to be able to recover ground, but that just sends a pretty big message that he's got so... Oh, again, right through the projectile.
It's kind of a...
Nope.
Kind of interesting. Oh, nice. Guy player playing a female... I mean, a guy player playing a female character and a girl player playing a male character.
It is pretty interesting. But again, it's my thing is, it's Ike.
E-K?
E-K.
Well,
and you don't have
somebody
to.
Somebody doesn't care. Anyway.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
If you smell what the fish is cooking.
Cooking fish.
Ooh. We are even 2-2. But wait a minute. If fish is cooking, is he cooking himself?
Oh. That's a deep truth right there.
That is deep.
Wumble Toastle. And now...
Ducks. This is such an interesting match. Are we running out of things to say? We don't have anything to say.
I really don't want anybody to misinterpret the fact that we're being silent, that we've run out of things to say. I got a million things to say.
Because really, if we really want to watch this, you'll be hearing like...
Who's getting killed? Are we killing zombies?
Yes, we are.
Oh, and he lands the throw. Nice. Up, and... Not away. No! Oh! Turns it right around! Sweet! No pressure.
Shh.
And it's so quiet in here, you could hear a cement nail drop.
Ding!
Not a pin, because there's still too much noise for that. Going for ether right in the middle of a combo. Kind of trying to send the message home that I could do the same thing too.
That was some skills right there.
That is some skills right there. But again, it gotta be careful. Gotta play it very safe. Fish can take a lot more risks than Hio can with his character, and he does.
Yep.
And whoa, will he get the meteor smash? No, and he's
out. Whoa!
He went for the risk, no reward.
Moving on to the next
round. It is 1-2. Hio still needs another win to be on even footing with Fish.
Right.
Both of these guys focusing.
This is crazy.
They're having zen-like moments in this friggin' game.
I'm tired, but it's not over yet.
No, it's got to be mentally draining.
Yeah.
I'm watching this, and I'm...
You're getting mentally...
I'm getting
tired.
We're
getting mentally drained.
I'm going to take a nap after this.
All right, you can just crawl under the table and take a nap or something.
I think they might want me to go home. I think I might get the you can't stay here speech. It might happen.
Yes.
Might.
Next stage. What is it?
And in this next stage, they are picking something that maybe they haven't picked before. Because loser picks
bigger,
badder,
better,
butter,
beater,
butter. Are we picking an Omega stage? What are we doing? Are we taking a break?
Give me a break.
Are we contemplating life?
You need and a Kit Kat bar or something?
And its intricacies? Are you okay, Frank and Bean? Yeah, I see him sweating from here. I'm sweating from here.
Yeah, you're sweating a little bit.
You are too!
No, I'm okay.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Right. I'm good. I'm good, bro. I'm good. No, you're sweating.
Alright.
Are we ready? Are you ready?
Or do you want to take a mental break right now? Because we need to take a mental break right now.
If she wins again, I'm gonna flip my chair.
We're gonna flip something.
I'm gonna flip my chair. Adamantium or aluminum, I don't care.
All right.
Ooh, trying to capitalize on that paralyzer, and he nails it sometimes.
Yep.
Sometimes doesn't. Ooh. Oh, and he got it. Racking up big damage right at the beginning of the match.
Not a good position.
That doesn't really matter. At this point, with that type of a damage... advantage.
That was a combo right there. Stun, grab, throw in the air, kick.
Again, because Ike is such a big character. No,
already 102% damage.
But you gotta keep in mind that if you hit the opposite direction at just the right time, you can counter effect the knockback. Okay? I don't know of any Smash players outside of computers that can do it perfectly each and every time, but every now and then they get it. And it looks like Hio's got it pretty much down to a science. She's very good at it.
Mm-hmm.
And she has to be with such a big character. Right. She's got to be used to getting hit and knocked around every so often, and bam! That could have gone very bad for Fish.
Right.
And nope! And nope! Right
alive.
Back. Look at that.
No.
Oh, no!
Fish said
there
nope!
There we go with the double hitter. Again, we see Fish, when it's his choice, picking the platform stages.
Right.
Okay? It does give his character a much better vantage point. It doesn't seem to really deter Hio's game, though.
Yeah.
It seems to be more of an advantage for Fish, not really a deterrent to Hio. Ooh, going for the
that was nice.
Two-sided smash.
Smart
recovered
to
right
back
away.
Up here.
Yeah. I see a lot of good spacing technique, and bam. Home run sword. Oop, wow, landing right in that zero range. Perfect spacing, again. And it's kind of... And it,
there it is.
There we go, there we go, there we go. Oh, nope. Oh. And, oh! And there she goes.
There she goes.
2-2. Here comes the fun part, if we've learned anything. 2-2.
2-2. Like two T's earlier today.
Two T's already left, bro.
He's gone.
He left. And what a crying shame that some of the competitors had to leave and not... Whoa! 1-2. We need... Here it comes. If Fish takes it, he has a two-stock advantage, zero damage. If he takes this match, that's it. He wins the eighth... His very first tournament, he'll win his very first tournament, and he will be the first place winner of the eighth Chibi's Boba tournament for this year. The eighth installment will declare Fish, leader of Sexy Fish, the winner if he wins this match. If not, we will be celebrating the arrival and the immediate dominance of Heel Life.
Ooh, nice dodge there.
It seems that as close as she gets, she's still trying to rack up that damage. Not afraid to get her hands dirty. Oh, that could have been bad.
That was bad. Oh!
And Fish takes it.
We have a winner.
We have a winner, ladies and gentlemen. He takes it.
Don't take off your shirt.
Stop. What are you doing? Hey. Tribal, you're ruining.
Okay. You want? I'll take it.
Giovanni, drop your wallet.
Okay. Wow. Very close match. Wow. Okay.
Fish.
Give another round of applause for Fish.
For Fish.
And you're right.
And Heel Life.
Woo! Wow. That was very exciting.
Wow.
That was very close.
My eyes, I can blink again.
Okay, we need to take a break.
We need a moment, but we'll be back to wrap up.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here with the winner, Mr. Fish, or Quackfish, whatever. Buddy, how you feeling?
I don't know, like really nervous.
You're still shaking?
Yes.
Why are you nervous? But then again, you were facing off against a girl.
I mean, the thing is...
Oh,
I mean, what you want? He won. He's a champ. He's a champ.
Okay, the thing is, I got like really nervous after the bracket reset because I could have won it like right there, but then I had to go through a whole bracket reset. But after I picked Zero Suit and won like the first game, I felt like really confident.
But let me ask you a question. Why did you decide to wait until the bracket reset to actually pick Zero Suit?
Did you wait?
Because if you didn't see the first match, like we had the very first feature match, it was me against her. And when I went Zero Suit, I got beat.
Yeah.
Okay, so you were still thinking about that very first match at the beginning of the day. Wow.
Good. That's why it's safe. If you're in winners, you pretty much have like, you can have fun for like the first three matches. But if it like messes up, then you go with your instinct.
Yeah.
So basically what you were doing is, well, I've always got another opportunity.
Yeah.
So you decided to test and see how your other characters would do against her.
Yeah. Because I really think that, again, motivation. Because earlier on today, I was playing like trash with Zero Suit. And then it just started getting better and better and better. And then it turned into that.
What do you think was your biggest difficulty facing off against Heel Life?
My biggest difficulty?
Or was Heel Life your biggest challenge?
Yes, she was. Did you not see the closest of games?
I'm just saying.
She's the only one who took multiple games off me. Other than... She's the only one who took games off me.
She's a tough cookie. Man.
Now, was it that you're not used to facing off against that level of an Ike, or what was it?
The thing is, I don't play Ikes at all, except Frank. He semi-plays Ike, but it's not as good as that. Like, shit.
Yeah.
It's, oof. Oh, yeah. You need a sense for that.
Yeah, well, yeah, we will. But but we understand. You're excited.
Yeah. You're the champ. for the first time here in Capitol. Were you a champ somewhere else, or this is your very first time that you were a champ?
No, this is my very first
time. Very first. How do you feel?
I feel...
Two mics.
I feel good.
Feels good, everybody.
Actually,
5 minutes away.
I feel sexy.
You feel sexy.
Now, speaking
nice.
Of sexy, you're the leader of the sexy fish?
Yep.
You're the kingfish.
Is that
right?
True? He's a leader, yep. Or he's just saying that?
Yep.
He's okay, so...
And right there, over there, Tribal, is actually the co-owner.
The co-owner.
Is he coming in? Is he robbing the frame again?
Yeah.
Okay. I guess you want to... Okay, if you want to say something.
Okay.
So how do you feel about your sexy fish leader?
I'm his slave. I have to carry all his bag.
Wait, did you lose a bet? Or is that the... That's the thing.
That's how it
goes.
That's the thing.
That's a... Oh. So what are you...
Coffee for him.
I'm the one that recruits for...
What should I say?
Just here.
You're out of frame, bro. You're out of frame.
Oh,
I'll be in the background.
Loser.
just look. Censor that out too.
I'm the one that part of the group. I'm the one that actually recruits players for Counter-Strike Global Offensive and Team Fortress 2. So I get like some parts of that, and he's one that recruits players for Smash Brothers. We play Smash Brothers Melee and Smash 4.
So well, that's pretty cool. So what are you now, Kingfish or Boss Fish?
Sexy Fish.
Exactly.
Okay, it stays sexy fish. Well, gentlemen, anything else you want to close off on, or what's up?
Oh yeah, you should. Whoever, if you play on a computer, you should totally add me on Steam. At I Head Sexy Fish, you'll totally find me,
that's
and I'll
your
be
stream
awesome.
Name? I mean, your Steam name?
Yeah.
I Head Sexy Fish.
I has
sexy fish
with an S there.
With an S. All right, cool.
Check it out, guys.
Well, gentlemen or fish, congratulations. We hope to see you again very soon.
You too, try.
Okay. Gentle fish.
Okay. All right, well, thank you very much, guys, for watching.
And that concludes the 8th edition or series special thing episode of the TV's tournament for 2015.
Check out our social media, Facebook, YouTube, all that good stuff.
Toy Bounty Hunters, Kafka.
MySpace.
Oh, Tom's mad. He doesn't want to talk to any of you guys. All right.
Peace. See you guys later.